I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making lemon icebox pie, and that's going to be for our Easter table, and it's something we can make a day ahead or a couple days ahead because it's a refrigerated pie. We need a crust, and that crust is going to be a graham cracker crust. You may buy those already made if you like, but the best ones are the ones that you make at home. So I'm going to use a recipe that you'll find in Betty's Kitchen for making graham cracker pie crust. I use about 1 1/4 cups of graham cracker crumbs, and also 1/4 cup of sugar, and mix that with 6 tablespoons of melted butter. And as you do that, you'll be able to have a nice mixture that you can form into a crust. Just let it be even along the bottom and up the sides of a pie plate, and then bake it at 375 degrees for 6 to 8 minutes. Here is our baked graham cracker pie crust. It was in the oven for 7 minutes at 375 degrees. So it looks brown around the edges, and it needs to cool off before we continue. So we're just going to let it sit on the counter until we can go on with our recipe. Our graham cracker pie crust has cooled, and I covered it with plastic wrap and put it in the refrigerator overnight, just for my convenience. You certainly don't have to leave it that long. You just need to let it cool down so you can put the filling in it. So we need to mix up our filling. We're going to start with 4 egg yolks, and I've got the whites saved in another bowl, and I'll use those later. To the egg yolks, I'm adding 1 can of sweetened condensed milk. That's a 14-ounce can. And then I have 1/2 cup lemon juice. You may use freshly squeezed lemons, or if you have lemon juice that is in a bottle, that's fine too. And I'm also adding 1 teaspoon of lemon zest or lemon rind, grated. And I think most of that is out. So we're going to blend this together. Here we have our filling, and we're going to pour that into our cooled crust. And this goes to the oven at 350 degrees, and it bakes for 5 minutes. And then we let it cool for 2 hours before continuing the recipe. Here is our graham cracker crust and lemon pie filling after it has been chilled for 2 hours in the refrigerator. So now we're going to make a topping, some meringue. We have the 4 egg whites that were left from separating the eggs and using the egg yolks in the filling. So we're going to beat these with an electric mixer, and we're going to beat until soft peaks form. Here we have soft peaks. I've measured out 1/4 cup of sugar, and I'm going to add it a little at a time and beat that in until stiff peaks form. Here we have stiff peaks, and so we're going to put our meringue topping over our filling. You want to seal this around the edge, and then you can deal with the other part, and if you want to put swirls in it or something like that, that's up to you. It usually looks nicer if you put something of a design on your meringue layer. But when you get it the way you want it, put it in a 350 degree oven and let it get gently brown. That's going to take maybe 10 to 15 minutes, but I'll keep track of the time here. Our lemon icebox pie is just out of the oven, and it took exactly 10 minutes to get to this point, and I thought, it's ready to come out. Now, What I'm going to do is let it sit on the counter and cool slightly, and then it can be refrigerated. And you want to refrigerate it until you're ready to serve it. That's why it's called an icebox pie. I'm going to take a little taste. Three layers. Meringue, and then that tangy lemon flavor, sweet and tangy, and then the graham cracker crust at the bottom. It tastes wonderful. I think you'll love it.